Mathem students, today we are going to begin with the new chapter, that is lesson number 21, transport and communication. So first of all, let us understand what is transport. Okay, transport means carrying people or goods from one place to another with the help of vehicle. That is the exact meaning of transport. Okay, have you ever imagined that in previous times when there were no vehicles, जब कोई भी vehicles नहीं थे, तो वो टाइम पे पीपल एक जगह से दूसरी जगह लोग कैसे जाते थे? How people used to move from one place to another? There were no vehicles, so of course they may be walking, right? वो चल के जाते होंगे. They may be walking from one place to another to move, okay? And how they used to transport the goods? They were using beast of burden like camel, horses, donkeys to move their goods from one place to another. And later on, they found out that they can travel through water also. But at that time, there were no boats, there were no ships, there were no steamers. So what they did? They made a raft, and on that raft, they used to travel through waterways. Okay. So these were the different ways in which people of earlier times used to travel. Now, with the invention of wheels, many things changed. With the invention of wheel, the cart was made, and then the modernized vehicles like scooter, bike, car, truck, train, everything came into existence and traveling became much more easy. Now, the question is, why people move from one place to another? Your daddy moves every morning to some place. Where he moves? He moves for his work. Right, so your dad moves from your home to his workplace, right? So he might be using vehicle like car, bus, bike, etc. And before the school, before this coronavirus, you all were also getting ready for the school and coming to the school through different mediums of transport. So we use different mediums of transport to move from one place to another. Now tell me something. If you want to go to your friend's house who is living nearby your house only, will you use an aeroplane to go over there? No, of course. We may go there by walking or cycling. Correct? And tell me something, if you want to go to some other city, suppose from Vapi you want to go to Mumbai, what you will use? You will use either a car or a bike or a bus or a train. And suppose if you want to move from one country to another, suppose from Vapi, from India, I want to move to America. Will I go there by walking or I will use a train? No, I will go there either by aeroplane or helicopter, right? So we are using different mediums of transport for different purposes. If you want to go nearby, you can use your car or your bike. If your place is very much near to your house, you can go there by walking or cycling. And if you want to travel somewhere very far away from our country, you can use aeroplane or helicopter. So we are using different modes of transport for different purposes. Okay. Now, you know which is the most expensive mode of transport? Yes, it is aeroplane and helicopter. It is the most expensive mode of transport, and also it is the quickest mode of transport. For example, if I want to go Goa from Vapi by car, it will take one day. But if I go by aeroplane, I'll reach there within few hours, 1 or 2 hours maybe. Okay, so it is said that aeroplane and helicopter is the fastest way of transport, and it is also expensive. Okay, you may have to give more bucks for going through that ways. Okay, what is the meaning of expensive? Expensive का मतलब होता है महंगा, and quickest का मतलब होता है सबसे जल्दी पहुंचाता है. Okay, so aeroplane and helicopter are quickest but also expensive mode of transport. Now coming to helicopter. Now tell me something. If you want to go to some mountain or if you want to go to some forest, will you go by car or bus? Will your car go upside the hill? No, it won't go. Will you go there by aeroplane? No, because aeroplane lands only at the airport. So how you will go there? You can go there by helicopter. What you can use? You can use helicopter to go to hills or forests. Now talking about helicopter, you know, whenever you want to go to some mountain or you want to go to some forest, you can use helicopter to go there. Because when if you want to go to some mountain, if you will use a car or bike, you cannot go there safely. But if you go by helicopter, it will land you safely over there. So helicopter is used to go to places like forest and also desert and also mountains. Okay. Now helicopter also helps in rescue operations. Many times there are some disaster events like floods and forest fire, and many people got caught in that. And through these helicopters, commanders perform some operations and they save the life of the people. So helicopter helps in the rescue operations also. Now there is one vehicle who goes out of the earth, who goes in the space. Do you know the name of that vehicle? It goes in the space, it sees the universe. Which is that vehicle? Yes, it is rocket. Okay, so with the help of modern technology, with the help of this globalization, we have got so many advanced modes of transport to travel to different places. Now you are living in Vapi, right? And you must have seen many modes of transport around yourself. We have seen bike, we have seen taxis, we have seen trains, we have seen buses. So there are many modes of transport around us. Okay. Now tell me, is there any metro station available in Vapi? No. Metro station is only available in Delhi and Kolkata. Okay. Delhi and Kolkata. Okay. So metro stations are only available in Delhi and Kolkata. And the metro trains are available to people to connect to different places. Okay, so we are having some modes of transport which are not available in another places. Like if you go to some villages, there may be no railway station or there may be no bus station, but luckily we have many facilities around us. Okay, now coming to villages. Now many of you must have went to village. Now tell me one thing, in village the roads are very narrow or it is very wide? How it is? You will tell me the roads are very narrow and also there are pit holes and they are very much zigzag, so big vehicles are not able to travel over there. But when you come to city, there are many big roads, there are wide roads, there are no pit holes, so big transport vehicles like trucks and buses can travel easily over there. So people in villages use different modes of transport like bullock carts, bicycle or cycle. But in cities they use a car, they use buses to travel from one place to another. Okay. Now I'm going to tell you something about public transport and private transport. Now what is public and private transport? Public transport is a transport facility available to us by the government. It is made available to us by the government, like buses, train. Okay, many people travel in that kind of vehicle and reach to their destinations. Coming to private, now private is our own vehicle which we use for our own use, like our bike, our car. We use our own personal vehicle to move to different places. Okay, so this is the differentiation between public and private transport. Public transport is available for everybody. Okay, anybody can use it to reach their destinations. But private vehicle is used by anybody who wants it personally. Okay, like if I am having my bike, I won't give it to someone else. I will use for myself, right? And bus, if bus is there, it is a mode of public transport. I cannot stop anybody. Hey, don't come and sit in my bus. This is my bus. All the seats are mine. I cannot see like that, right? But if it is your car, you won't allow any outsider to come and sit in your car, right? Because it is your private vehicle. So this is the basic difference between public transport and private transport. Now, here in Chennai, there is mass rapid transport system. Okay, MRTS. Now due to this MRTS, that is mass rapid travel system, people can go to different places very quickly. And also in Mumbai you must have seen there are local trains. which connects different places, and people can travel to different destinations at cheaper rate. Now, okay, we are going to learn the next topic, that is safety rules and travel. Okay, now we are going to learn the next topic, that is safety rules and travel. You all know that we should follow the safety rules while crossing the road. Okay, whenever you are crossing the road, you should go in the road along with your adult. You should not cross the road yourself. Okay, and you should only cross the road when the traffic signal is red. Okay, and whenever you are crossing the road, you should use the zebra crossing if it is there. Okay, and whenever you are crossing, do not run, just walk properly. We all know that the traffic is moving very fast. There is much crowd in the cities and towns. So it is very dangerous if you are crossing it haphazardly. So you should cross the road with all the road safety, because if you will not take care, you might be getting an accident and it will create a harm to your body. So it is very necessary to follow the safety rules whenever you are crossing the road. Okay, we must be knowing about the traffic policeman. Who is traffic policeman? He controls the traffic. Okay, and you should always follow the traffic lights whenever you are riding a bicycle. Now you all know there are three traffic lights, that is red, yellow and green. What does red says? Red says stop, yellow says get ready, and green says go. So you should follow this traffic lights. Okay, agar red signal hai to you should stop. If that is yellow signal, then you should get ready to go, and finally at the green signal you should move. But whenever you are crossing the road by walking, you should only cross the road when the signal is red, because then only the vehicles will be at their place and you can go very safely. Okay, now whenever you are in the vehicle, for example, if you are waiting for your school bus, and when you are getting in the school bus, you should stand in a queue. And whenever you are inside the school bus, never put your hands or head out of the bus, because it may create a dangerous situation for you. Right? And follow the traffic rules for your safety. Fine? Now students, let us understand what is communication. Okay, what is communication? Communication means expressing one's ideas, thoughts or feelings either by speaking, writing or by some body movement or by signals. Okay, that is the exact meaning of communication. Fine. Now I'll tell you one example. There was one boy whose name was Rahul, and his birthday was coming next week. So he wanted to celebrate his birthday at his home. So he wanted to give invitation to his friends. So the friends who are there in the school, he will tell them to come at the birthday party. But what about the friends who lives far away? What he will do? He will telephone them, right? And Rahul's mother told Rahul that you need to invite your uncle who lives in Delhi. So please write a invitation letter to him. So here he will use a postcard. And what about his friend who lives in Singapore? What he will use for him? He can use an email. So here Rahul is using different modes of transport for delivering his invitation message, right? Now you know, in earlier times, people were using different modes to communicate. It was not always possible to speak or write. So in earlier times, they used to beat a drum or they used to release a smoke signal in order to communicate. And you know, in earlier times, pigeons were also used as a medium of communication. The messages were tied on the legs of the pigeon and then they were flew away. So these were the different modes which were used in the earlier times and which were very time consuming also, right? But nowadays we have many modes, modern modes of communication, and you all are very well aware about it. Now you know, have you ever seen Indian classical dance performance in which the artist is using different mudras, and the people who knows these mudras can understand what the artist is trying to tell you. Okay, I'll show you some mudras, what artist is using, different kinds of mudras and telling us. Let us have a look at the
students. Here are some mudras which is used by Indian classical dance performer. Can you see she is performing the classical dance, and can you see the movements of her hands? Yes. Now see, if the movement of hand is like this, this means it is a flag. This movement shows arrow shaft. This movement shows waxing moon. This movement shows tongs, and this movement shows heroism. So they use different mudras, and with the help of this mudras, they try to communicate their feelings to people. Okay, I already told you that different modes of communications are used, such as post letter, messages, fax, email, telephone. Now we will look here how we can write a letter. Okay, can you see a boy over here? He is told to write a postcard. He is told to write a letter to his grandparents in Delhi, and he is living in Chennai. Now let us see how Rahul is writing a letter. See, whenever you want to write a letter, you can write it on a postcard, you can write it on an inland letter, and then you can put it in an envelope, and then you can post it. See, first you can see the image. First, whenever you want to write a letter, first is this thing which you have to perform. First you have to write the message, whatever you want to convey in the letter. Then put the letter in a stamped envelope and write address. This type of envelope is there, on which you have to put a stamp, and then you have to write the address. Then you can put the letter in the letter box. From that letter box, postman collects letter. At post office, letters are sorted, stamped and put into different mailbox. When the postman collects the letter, it goes into the post office, where postmaster differentiates the letter. They sort the letter and put it in different mailboxes. Now letters are loaded into mail vans and sent to the locations using aeroplane, trains and ships. Okay, ek bar letter mail ho jate hai, baad mein wo jo apne locations pe different locations pe bheje jate hai by using airplanes, trains or ships. A postman delivers the letter to the address mentioned. Jo bhi address likha hota hai us pe postman ja ke letter de deta hai. Now finally the letter is now in the hands of the person it was addressed to. So what is the first process? First you have to write the letter, then you have to put it in stamped envelope, and you have to write the correct address. Then you can put the letter in the letter box. From there postman can collect the letter, and then it goes into post office where it is sorted. After sorting, it is sent to their locations by using different modes of transport. Then the postman delivers the letter at the address mentioned, and finally it reaches to its destination. Okay, so this is the way in which the letter reaches its destination. Fine.
Whenever you are writing the letter, it is very much necessary that you mention PIN on it. Now what is PIN? PIN is postal index number. Okay, it is a 6-digit number. How many digit number? 6. Okay, PIN is a 6-digit number, and the full form of PIN is postal index number. And if you are mentioning this PIN, your letter will reach at the correct destination. So PIN ensures that your letter reaches at the correct destination. Okay, every place has different PIN. Like the PIN of Vapi is 396191. So different places are having different PINs. Okay, and if you want to send the messages earlier, if you want to send the messages urgently, you can use courier service, or you can also use speed post. Hi students, we are going to learn about telephone. Telephone is the quickest means of communication. If you want to tell something, if you want to convey a message to person, you can convey it in seconds by using this telephone. You can just telephone and speak whatever you want to say. Okay, whether he is in another country or in another city, you can convey the message very quickly. Now suppose if the person is living in the same place, in the same country, you can use STD. Okay, and if the person is living in another country, then you can use ISD. Okay, so STD for the person who lives in the same country, And ISD for the person who does not live in same country, he lives in another country, then you have to use ISD. Now what is the full form of STD? Subscriber Trunk Diary. And the full form of ISD is International Subscriber Diary. Okay. Suppose my friend is Neha. She is living in Mumbai. If I want to telephone her, I will use STD. And suppose Neha is living in US. And if I want to communicate a message, I will use ISD. Okay. Now, before the inventions of the mobile, there were PCOs, public call office. What were they? There were PCOs where people used to go and telephone their relatives or friends. But after the invention of mobile, everything just got changed. All the people in this world are now having mobile, which is a wireless device. And through that mobile, you can send the messages, you can call, you can have many type of social media chattings with another person. So now entirely way of communication has been changed. Now one another way of communicating with a person quickly is through fax. Now if you want to send a fax, it is very necessary that you have telephonic connection. Okay? You should have telephonic connection for sending the fax, and fax helps you to deliver the message quickly. Fine? Now coming to email. Now we will learn about email. Now email, the full form of email is electronic mail. Okay? And it is very quickest and affordable means of communication. Right? For sending the email, there should be internet connectivity with your device. Suppose you have a laptop, if you have a computer, if you have mobile and you want to send an email, aapke paas internet connection hona chahiye. If you have internet connection, you can send messages all over the world very quickly and in affordable way. Now, email, you have got the idea what is email, right? You can send email only if you have internet connectivity. Now, after this, let us discuss about what is personal communication. Personal communication. Personal communication means the communication which is private, which is not for everyone. Like if there is some topic which you and your friend wants to communicate, you will not say it on a TV or radio, or you will not shout. You will just call, or you will send a message, or you will send an email. Right? So this personal communication means the private communication, which is between two or more people, which is not for many people, which is between some group of people or two people. Okay? So private communication, modes of private communication, you can say telephone, you can say letter, fax, email. These are the different modes of personal communication. Let us learn about mass communication. What is mass communication? When a message is delivered to many people at one time, that is known as mass communication. For example, I want to give one news to many people at one time, what I will use? I will use mass communication. I can use TV, I can use radio, I can use newspaper, I can use magazines. Okay? So these are the different modes of mass communication. Now as we know that in India, many newspapers are available in almost all Indian languages. So people can access to different news through newspaper. And we all know that through radio, through TV, we are getting the news from the news channel. We are getting to know what is happening worldwide. Okay? And also apart from that, TV and radio is also a means to relax. Whenever you are getting free time, you can watch movies, you can listen to songs and make yourself relaxed, right? Now coming to magazines. Magazines are a great way of endorsing. Many advertisements are made through magazines. Coming to cinemas, you know in cinemas many social messages are made. जैसे आप कभी movie देखने जाते हो तो आपने देखा होगा ना कि वो लोग advertise करते हैं कि smoking is injurious to health, बेटी बचाओ बेटी पढ़ाओ. This many social messages are conveyed to many people at one time through this media. Now you know because of this modes of communication, the whole world has changed to a global village. All the people are connected to each other because of this modern means of communication. Okay?